Hey folks, so today is my review of the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette. So if you guys are curious for 5 different looks that you can use with this palette, they'll all be on a playlist on my channel page, or if you hit like a videos playlist, they're all there. Alright, so first thing I'm just going to talk about the packaging in the palette itself. So this is the box packaging that it comes in. Really cute, nice and like nice texture on the packaging. I don't know why, but nice packaging entertains me. I think it does to anybody. Sweet peach and it smells like peaches. That's a kind of another thing I just kind of want to add in here. I'm really not too sure about the whole like smelly eyeshadow thing and palettes that smell like stuff. This is really my first one other than the Tarte one, the Tarte Bunny palette that kind of smells like Oreos. This is the only one that I bought like knowing going into it that it is going to smell like something. I don't know if I like that. So I'm still sort of on the fence as to whether or not I like the idea of having scented eyeshadows. Mostly just because I try to avoid perfume and scented fragrance products on my face as much as possible. Which is funny seeing as I bought this palette and I'm like, yay, it smells like peaches. But in terms of like my skincare and stuff like that, I like using sort of like base skincare that doesn't have any fragrance. Just find that I try to avoid it just because it might react with my skin. I have sensitive skin, I have dry skin. That being said, I feel like the scent is kind of one of the main selling points for these palettes. They obviously have the chocolate ones, peanut butter ones, and all that other stuff that smells. So the actual scent, it does smell a little bit like fuzzy peaches. It's definitely that sort of like chemically candied peach smell. It's not like an actual like peach, like, oh, I smell like fresh peaches. It definitely has that sort of like fake candy smell. It definitely smells really good, and so when you open it up on your like vanity or whatever, you do smell it. You don't smell it on your eyes, like it just kind of dissipates, but if you, you know, open it up and like smell it, it smells good. So it's kind of entertaining, but it's just still sort of a weird idea for me personally. So the actual palette packaging itself is sort of this like tin magnet with like the peach. I think it's beautiful. Like, I love this ombre look and I love like the actual tin. I don't have any other palettes like that. So let me know in the comments if this reminds you, if you have this palette or any of the other ones that are similar to this. Does it not remind you of those little kits that you used to get in grade school that had like a compass and like a like protractor and all that stuff? Those little like math kits. This is like that tin packaging. I don't know why, but I first opened it and I was like, why does this remind me of grade school? But yeah, that's just kind of what it reminds me of. So it does have this like magnetic closure. One thing I will say though, it's not the strongest magnet, and it kind of like, see how it's like, I don't know. So even though it is sort of that tin metal packaging, I feel like it's a little bit flimsy. So I actually keep the box because I think if I was going to travel with it, I'd want to just keep it in the box. I don't know. Okay, so then opening up the actual palette itself, you get these 18 eyeshadows. You get the nice little mirror with like, you know, sweet peach, the little peach guy. He's kind of cute. For $60, 18 eyeshadows, not too bad. $3.25 per eyeshadow, which really at that point you're paying like drugstore prices. You really can't even get like a single NYX eyeshadow for $3, I don't think. So really the price alone, you're getting a lot of different options, a lot of different colors for that price, which I do like. Moving on to the actual eyeshadows themselves, there are a couple different textures in this palette for eyeshadows. So there's a couple mattes. So that's colors like Peaches and Cream, Georgia, let me see, Puree, Summer Yum, Charmed, I'm sure. Those colors are more on the matte side, and those ones actually perform really well. No issues with them, they blended nicely. So obviously the lighter colors, depending on your skin tone, might come off a little bit more chalky, but I had a really good time using Puree and Summer Yum. Those ones are a couple of my favorites in this palette. Obviously Summer Yum is like gorgeous, I really love that color quite a bit. Got some shimmer shades in here, so that's colors like Nectar, Luscious, Caramelized, Cobbler, Just Peachy, Bellini, this one, you know. Most of the other shades do have a little bit of shimmer. And then there's a couple in here that are weird, and it's like those are the same eyeshadow textures that I always complain about. I hate it. It's almost like a matte with sparkle in it where the sparkle doesn't show up. So really what it ends up doing is just making like a shitty matte color. And that's more of Candied Peach and this one, which is Talk Derby to me. Those ones, not so good. Also, for some reason, Delectable is not as good as the other shimmers in this palette, as well as Tempted. Now, in terms of value, having 18 eyeshadows and only having about 3, maybe 4 that I don't like, that's actually not too bad. I was still able to make some of these shades work. It's just they took a little bit more effort. It tends to be something that companies have a lot of issue with, is making good purple shades. I don't know why that's so difficult. I think it's like a formula thing. If you go and watch day 5, you'd notice that I had a lot of issues with some of these darker shades. You get to see sort of my difficulty blending them out in the lid. So the lighter colors and the other shades in this palette, actually actually performed really well and I really liked them. I did get a comment last week to mention sort of the longevity of eyeshadows. That's not something I normally mention because I actually just use like a really good eyeshadow primer. So I use Urban Decay Primer Potion that I've used for years. And basically because I use a primer, I don't really see any lack of pigmentation in my eyeshadows. Typically, if it's a really bad eyeshadow formula, that's only when it starts to fade. But if I don't mention it, then that pretty much means I can get through like a whole day and they don't fade or lose color or pigmentation. Alright, so I'm going to talk a little bit about who I think this palette might be good for. I feel like this palette might be good for people who like neutrals with a little pop of color. So because you have this lighter shade and a couple of these fun darker mattes, you can definitely pull a lot of looks out of it. I think that this palette is more designed for like everyday wearable looks. These four darker shades right here aren't the best performing. That just means for me, I'm going to be pulling a lot more of the lighter shades and not really touching these darker colors just because I know that they're not the best. That being said, this is a palette that I am going to keep. I'm not going to return it. I like a lot of the colors and I like the concept of it. And I'm not going to lie, I really do like the scent. It is good for everyday, like going to work kind of stuff. Obviously, you do have those darker shades if you wanted to sort of kick it up a notch. If you have these shades in your collection already, it's really pointless to buy this palette unless you are a fan of like the peach scent or Too Faced as a brand, or you're a collector of like cute makeup, because like, let's get real, this is adorable. So it is a little bit gimmicky in the sense that it's cute and smells like peaches, but a lot of the shades in this palette are actually really good and I really do like them. Some of my favorites in here are Bellini, I really love Caramelized, Cobbler, Nectar is gorgeous, these two matte shades are gorgeous. I really like this other matte shade over here. The green is nice as well. It's a nice sort of addition to this palette if you wanted to take it more of like an olive tone. Really, really pretty. So yeah, this is a palette that I do like. I do recommend it if you feel like it's something that you might need and you might use. I don't recommend that anyone buy palettes just for the hype. So overall, I do recommend this palette. I feel like it has a really good bang for its buck for $60 for 18 eyeshadows. For me, it would be kind of $60 for 14 eyeshadows just because I had those four that I didn't necessarily like. Like I said, I can still use them, but they're just sort of more of a pain in the ass to use. Now, obviously, I don't suggest to anyone to purchase palettes that you don't think you're going to use. You'll know if you're not somebody who's going to like these shades. If you don't think that the shades are going to work on you, don't get the palette. That's pretty simple. If you're not buying it for those darker shades, then I do recommend it. For me, this is definitely going to be a palette that I reach for more in the spring and summer, just for like lighter looks, like something I'm wearing today. This is kind of something I would throw on in the summer, just quick and simple and easy. So obviously, you can wear whatever you want any time of year, but I feel like typically and traditionally, this is more of like a spring summer palette. So that wraps up the palette review. Hopefully, this helps you out a little bit in deciding maybe whether or not to purchase this palette if you're interested in it. I try to touch base on as many things as I can. As always, if you guys want to see the colors and how they perform on the lid, just refer back to my 5 videos where I used this palette for a week. Like applying colors on the eyelid is the best way to show how they work on the eyelid, just because finger swatches never really accurately represent how an eyeshadow is going to work on my eyelid. And so yeah, if you guys want to see how they blend out and color payoff and that kind of thing, just refer back to those videos. I will let you guys know that I'm moving forward with the palette series, and next week is going to be the Kat Von D Shade Light Eye. This is just sort of the neutral palette, and a lot of people have been asking me to do this one. I feel like it might be nice to take a break from color and just do some neutral looks. So yeah, hopefully you guys are excited for that. And yeah, hopefully everyone is doing good. And until my next video, I'll talk to all of you soon.